using the scientific method in the sky. Hey there, Star Fam. I am Trace, astro enthusiast and science communicator. Science is a way of thinking, of solving problems, but it's not always obvious how different scientists apply this way of thinking in their respective fields. Take astronomy, for example. How do you act out the scientific method on a giant floating cloud of gas hundreds of light years away? To apply the scientific method to the stars, we need a problem or a question. Scientists love questions. In an earlier Stargazers episode, we talked about star colors, asking why different stars are different colors. Now, we can assume some things, but to answer this question reliably, we need observations and data. For example, if we wanted to know why all the red stars were red or the blue ones were blue, we'd look at them through telescopes over and over again. These observations would serve to gather data about the stars, like their colors, their temperatures, their brightnesses, their sizes and their masses, and anything else that we can think of. More data, more better. Then we would look at all the data we've gathered and try and use that to explain the colors of the stars. For example, which property is most closely related to the color of the star? Is it the temperature, the size, the distance from us? From the data, an explanation or hypothesis is then put forth, and astronomers start to debate if that hypothesis fits with the data they observed. It turns out the colors of the stars are very closely related to their temperatures. Hotter stars appear blue and cooler stars appear red, so that is our hypothesis, theory, or explanation. From there, we have to experiment and test our hypothesis. For that, we'll look at the stars some more and try and find data that provides evidence in favor of or against our hypothesis. That's right, we want to know if we're wrong. In this case, our hypothesis has proven to be correct, but sometimes scientists are wrong, and when that happens, we go back and we try again. We will modify the hypothesis or explanation and then gather more data and more observations to provide evidence in favor of or against that new hypothesis. And in this way, the scientific method is self-correcting. Throughout history, we know that this process can take months, years, decades, even centuries, but eventually, with lots of hypotheses and data, we will come to the facts. That said, it's all based on one big assumption, that the same natural laws and processes that operate in our present-day scientific observations have always operated in the whole universe, everywhere, throughout all of time. If, say, the laws of physics or chemistry or geology had changed over the last million years, we might be in trouble. Without this basic assumption, we cannot reliably be practitioners of the scientific method or hope to unlock the secrets of the natural world using science. My seventh grade teacher had a mnemonic for this scientific method. It's SHEOC: state the problem, hypothesis, experiment, observation, conclusion. Rinse, collect, and repeat. That's science. Thanks, Mr. Odell. And thank you for watching. I am Trace. Keep looking up.